विशाल कंटिन्यू विथ आवर फोर्थ चैप्टर ऑफ फिजिक्स क्लास 11 मोशन इन अ प्लेन एग्जाम्पल नंबर 4.2 फाइंड द मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डिरेक्शन ऑफ द रिजल्टेंट ऑफ टू वैक्टर्स ए एंड बी इन टर्म्स ऑफ देयर मैग्नीट्यूड एंड एंगल थीटा बिटवीन दैम लेट वैक्टर ओ पी एंड वैक्टर ओ क्यू रिप्रेजेंट द टू वैक्टर्स ए एंड बी मेकिंग एन एंगल थीटा सो दिस इज ओ पी It is represented by vector A and OQ, which represents vector B. And this is the angle theta between vector A and B. Now, if we complete the parallelogram by drawing a parallel line from the head of A to vector B and from head of B to vector A, then we get the parallelogram O, Q, S, and P. From the common origin, if you draw the diagonal, this OS diagonal is the resultant of vector A and B. By parallelogram method of vector addition, vector OS is the resultant R. Okay, this one. Therefore, R is equal to A plus B. Now draw SN perpendicular to OP and PM perpendicular to OS. So from S, we draw perpendicular SN to OP produced. And from P, you draw perpendicular PM to OS. This angle I take as alpha, this angle I take as beta. If this angle is theta, then obviously this angle also will be theta. Now this angle, this vector is B and this vector also will be B because they are the same in magnitude, same in direction. So now this vector B I can resolve into two components. Along the x-axis it is Bxi cap B cos theta and along the y-axis it is Byj equal to B sin theta. In right triangle OSN by Pythagoras, you have got the right triangle O. S and N is the right angle. So if you apply Pythagoras, it is OS square equal to ON square plus SN square. Okay, I have written here. But ON from the figure, ON is OP plus PN and OP is vector A and PN is B cos theta. So but ON equal to OP plus PN, OP is A plus PN is B cos theta and SN we have resolved this as B sin theta. So we write here B sin theta. Now put these two values here. So we get here OS square equal to, instead of this, A plus B cos theta whole square plus SN is B sin theta square. Expand this using A plus B whole square. So here is A square plus 2AB cos theta plus B square cos square theta and this square is plus B square sin square theta. A square as it is plus 2AB cos theta as it is plus from these two you take B square common. Here you get cos square theta plus sin square theta and this value is 1. So we can say that a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. Now OS, we know that it is resultant R. So we can put here instead of OS square, R square. Take a square root on both the sides. So you get R is equal to under the square root a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta. A and b are the vectors and theta is the angle between a and b. This is the magnitude of resultant of vector a and b. This is known as law of cosine. In triangle OSN, you have got triangle OSN. In this triangle, if I apply here sine alpha, then sine alpha is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So opposite is SN and hypotenuse is OS. So I apply here sine alpha is equal to SN by OS. SN keep here and OS transfer and multiply here. So we get here SN equal to OS sine alpha. But OS is your resultant R. So put here R sin alpha. And in triangle PSN, this smaller triangle PSN, this is angle theta. Apply here sin theta. So sin theta again, opposite side, that is SN divided by hypotenuse, that is PS. So I put here sin theta equal to SN by SP. SP transfer over here, so here remains SN equal to SP sin theta. But SP is nothing but B. Vector B. So you can say B sin theta. Now R sin alpha is value of SN and B sin theta is value of SN. So both you can equate. So you can write R sin alpha equal to B sin theta. Sin theta transfer over here, it will go denominator. Sin alpha transfer over here, it will go denominator. So you get R by sin theta equal to B by sin alpha, call it equation 1. Similarly, we can prove that PM is equal to A sin alpha equal to B sin beta. And this can be written as A by sin beta equal to B by sin alpha, call it number 2. Combining 1 and 2, we get R by sin theta equal to A by sin beta equal to B by sin alpha. दिस इज नोन एज लॉ ऑफ साइंस. फ्रॉम इक्वेशन वन, फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन आर बाय साइन थीटा इक्वल टू बी बाय साइन अल्फा इम्प्लाइज दिस साइन अल्फा ट्रांसफर हियर एंड साइन थीटा एंड आर ट्रांसफर ओवर हियर. सो गेट साइन अल्फा इक्वल टू बी बाय आर साइन थीटा. इन राइट ट्राइंगल ओ एस एन, ओके दिस ट्राइंगल ओ एस एंड एन, अप्लाई दिस एंगल इज अल्फा, अप्लाई टेन अल्फा. सो टेन अल्फा इज इक्वल टू अपोजिट साइड डिवाइड बाई एडजेसेंट साइड. सो अपोजिट साइड इज एस एन एंड एडजेसेंट साइड इज ओ एन. सो आई राइट हियर टेन अल्फा इज इक्वल टू एस एन बाई ओ एन. बट ओ एन फ्रॉम द फिगर ओ एन इज इक्वल टू ओ पी प्लस पी एन एंड ओ पी इज ए एंड पी एन इज बी कॉस थीटा एंड एस एन इज बी साइन थीटा. सो वॉट वी कैन पुट हियर, फर्स्ट आई एम पुटिंग ओ एन एस ओ पी प्लस पी एन, एस एन एस बी साइन थीटा एंड ओ पी एस ए प्लस पी एन एस बी कॉस थीटा एंड दिस इज द डिरेक्शन. सो वी हैव फाउंड द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द रिजल्टेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ थीटा, पोजिशन वैक्टर एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट. द पोजिशन ऑफ वैक्टर आर ऑफ अ पार्टिकल पी लोकेटेड इन अ प्लेन विथ रेफरेंस टू द ओरिजिन ऑफ एन एक्स वाई रेफरेंस फ्रेम इज वैक्टर आर इज इक्वल टू एक्स आई कैप प्लस वाई जे कैप वेर एक्स वाई आर द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ वैक्टर आर अलॉन्ग एक्स वाई एक्सिस. सो यू हैव गॉट अ पॉइंट पी एंड दिस हैज गॉट द पोजिशन with respect to the origin as r. If I draw from p perpendicular to x axis it is x I cap and from p to y axis it is y j cap. So this position of point p is written as r cap equal to x I cap plus y j cap, okay, in two dimension. So these are the x and y are the component of r along x and y axis. You can also call this x and y as the coordinate of the point p. So this is a position of a point in xy plane, okay, given by r is equal to xi plus yj cap. Suppose a particle moves along the curve, okay, so now a particle is moving along the curve, okay, this is the curve and particle is moving on this curve. It is at P at time t and P dash at time t dash, then the displacement is delta r vector equal to r dash vector minus r vector, direction from P to P dash. Now here, as I said that this is the path of an object, okay, it is moving along this curve. At time t, the particle is at point P and at time t dash, it is reaching at P dash. Then with respect to origin, the position of P will be vector r and position for P dash will be vector r dash. Then this will be the displacement. Okay, from the final position minus the initial position will give you the displacement, that is delta r, the displacement, and it is towards from P to P dash. This arrow shows from P to P dash. So this is the displacement, okay, the straight line joining P and P dash. Final position minus the initial position will give you the displacement, or you can say the position vector of P dash minus the position vector of P will give you the displacement delta r. In component form, delta r is equal to r dash. R dash, see, already I gave you the position of r as x I cap plus y j cap. Now if I want to write for r dash, it will be x dash I cap plus y dash j cap. Okay, so I am just writing here for vector r dash as x dash I cap plus y dash j cap and for vector r x I cap plus y j cap. Now I component together and j component together. So you get delta r vector equal to x dash minus x I cap plus y dash minus y j cap. And this is the difference. So you can write as delta x I cap plus this difference you can write as delta y j cap. So this is the displacement. Velocity, average velocity v of an object is the ratio of displacement and the corresponding time interval. This we know that velocity is the ratio of displacement divided by the time interval. So velocity v equal to delta r by delta t. Delta r, from here you can write delta x I cap plus delta y j cap divided by delta t. Divide each term by delta t, so delta x by delta t I cap plus delta y by delta t j cap. This can be written as Vx I cap plus this can be as written Vy j cap. Instantaneous velocity is given by limiting value of average velocity as a time interval approaches 0. So when you take this delta t approaching towards 0, then you get instantaneous velocity. So velocity v, or you can say either velocity or instantaneous velocity, it is the same. So velocity v equal to limit delta t tends to 0 delta r by delta t. So this in a calculus it is dr by dt. The direction of velocity at any point on the path of an object is tangential to the path at that point and is in the direction of motion. Now if you want to write the direction of, find the direction of the velocity, then suppose I want to find at this point, then you draw a tangent at this point. Okay, like this you draw the tangent. So this tangent will give you the direction of the velocity. Okay, and it will be in the motion of the particle. So if particle is moving in this direction, so velocity in this direction, but it will be tangential to that point. Okay, you have to draw the tangent and that will give you the direction of the velocity. Velocity in component form, v is equal to dr by dt. So we can write limit delta t tends to 0 and dr by dt we can write as delta x by delta t I cap plus delta y by delta t j cap. Limit you give to both the terms, so v equal to limit delta t tends to 0 delta x by delta t I cap plus limit delta t tends to 0 delta y by delta t j cap. And these in a calculus, dx by dt I cap plus dy by dt j cap. These are the component of the velocity in x and y. So you can write this as a vx I cap plus vy j cap. So this is the velocity. Now the magnitude of velocity is v equal to square root of vx square plus vy square. Okay, this is the magnitude. And the direction of velocity given by angle theta is tan theta equal to vy by vx. Theta equal to tan transfer over here, so you get tan inverse vy by vx. Okay, we'll keep this much for today. Thank you very much.